Good morning students, in this video we are going to solve question number 11 of exercise 13.2. Now the question is, a school has 8 periods a day, each of 45 minutes duration. How long would each period be if the school has 9 periods a day, assuming the number of school hours to be same? Students, in this question it is given that for a fixed school time, if there are 8 periods, then duration of each period is 45 minutes. Therefore, here I have drawn one table. In first row, number of periods, and in second row, duration of a period, means duration of one period in minutes. Therefore, if there are 8 periods, then duration of one period is 45 minutes. Now students, here it is asked that if in place of 8 periods there are 9 periods, then what is duration of one period if the school time is same? Therefore students, we can write here 9, and we have to find out time of each period or duration of each period if number of periods are 9. Now students, we observe here, if number of periods increases, then time of one period decreases. I repeat, if number of periods increases, then time of one period decreases. Therefore, it is example of inverse proportion, or in this case, between these two quantities, there is inverse proportion. Students, if you consider this value x1, this value x2 for first quantity, and for second quantity, first value y1 and second value y2. Now here, inverse proportion, therefore product is constant. Therefore, x1 y1 is equal to x2 y2. Therefore, we can write here, inverse proportion in this case, inverse proportion, therefore x1 y1 or x1 into y1 is equal to x2 into y1. Therefore students, x1 8, y1 45, therefore we can put these values here 8 into 45, which is equal to x2 9, and we have to find out y2. Therefore 9 into y2. Now students, here if we shift this 9 from RHS to LHS, then it will divide on LHS. Therefore 8 into 45 divided by 9, which is equal to y2. Now 9 and 45 both are divisible by 9. 9 ones are 9, 9 5s are 45. Now 8 into 5. Therefore 8 into 5 is equal to y2. Now 8 5s are 40. Therefore here we can write, therefore 40 is equal to y2. Therefore y2 is equal to 40. Therefore students, here we can write 40. Therefore students, our final answer is 40 minutes. Therefore we can write here 40. Students, therefore we can say that here, for the same school time, if the number of periods are 9, then duration of one period is 40 minutes. Students, I hope it is clear to you. Students, here we have completed chapter number 13, that is direct and inverse proportion. Students, we will start next chapter in next video. Thank you and have a nice day.